Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and today I'm helping you practice for your verbal fraction test. And we're trying to do these problems without using a calculator or paper, just using our heads and deciding the answer. The question here is, would the sum be greater or less than 1? To do this in your head, decide if each fraction is more or less than 1/2. The reason I would say that is because we know that if we had exactly 1/2 and we added 1/2 to that, we would get 1. So if we have less than 1/2 for each of our fractions, we're going to have less than 1. And if we have more than 1/2 for both of our fractions, we're going to have more than 1/2. And what if we had 1 that's less and 1 that's more? Well, that's a little harder, and I'm not going to give you those on your verbal fraction test. But I am going to show you an example of that at the end. Okay. So let's look at this. 9/10. Is it more than 1/2 or less than 1/2? What is half of 10? Half of 10 is 5/10. That would be half, right? So we have 9/10. So our 9/10 is greater than 1. We know that this symbol right here means greater than, and this symbol is less than. So when I'm saying greater than and less than, that's what I'm talking about. Get that back in there, on frame there. Okay, so now what about 3/5? Well, half of 5 is 2.5. And 3 is more than that, so we also know that the second part is greater than 1/2. I don't know why I put 1. So the first part, 9/10, is greater than 1/2. And 3/5 is also greater than 1/2. So our answer is greater than 1, or that. Okay, so I don't have to write anything down. I was just writing it down so you could follow me. Let's see if we can do this without writing anything down. What about 3/8? Is that less than 1/2 or greater than 1/2? Well, 3/8, 4/8 would be half, so this is less than. And what about 3/16? Half of 16 would be 8/16, so this is also less. So this is less than 1/2, and this is less than 1/2. If I have less than 1/2 for both of my parts, I'm not going to get to 1. That means that my answer is less than 1, and I can write it this way. All right, what about this one? 3/4 and 5/6. Is this greater than 1/2 or less than 1/2? Half of 4 would be 2, and we have 3, so that's greater than 1/2. What about 5/6? Well, half of 6 would be 3. We have 5, so that's also greater than 1/2. So I have more than 1/2 in my first part, and I have more than 1/2 in my second part, so I'm going to have more than 1 or greater than 1 for my sum of those two parts. So I'm not asking you to tell me what the answer is. I'm just wanting you to get a sense of, is that less than 1 or greater than 1? Okay, next one, we have 1/5 and 3/8. What you want to do is go back and decide, is this going to be more than 1/2 or less than 1/2 on each one of those? Could you do it in your head at this point? 1/5 is less than 1/2 because half of 5, as we said earlier, was 2.5. And we have less than that, so we have less than 1. Left arrow points left. And then 3/8, well, we said half of 8 would be 4, and we don't have that much. We have less than that, so we have less than 1. I keep saying 1. It's definitely less than 1. It's also less than 1/2. So both parts are less than 1/2. If both parts are less than 1/2, then I know for sure my answer is going to be less than 1. Okay, the two more. This one, you could do the same way. Move this up a little bit. You could do it the same way because you can see that I have less than 16, than 8, half of 16, and I have less than half of 16 again. But here, if you have the same denominator, there's maybe an easier way, and that is just to add your two numerators together. 3 and 7 is 10 sixteenths, and we know that 1 is equal to 16 sixteenths, and we definitely don't have 16, so I know that our answer is less than 1. So if you have the same denominator, you have that availability. And the last one I want to look at is the hardest one, and I did not put this on your verbal test because it's a little harder to do. As you got better at it, I could add that in, maybe in the next quarter. But what about this one? Well, 7/8, half of 8 is 4. So we know this is greater than 1/2. And half of 16 is 8, so we know this is less than 1/2. So these are the trickier ones because I have more than a half, but then I have less than a half. Do they add up to be a whole or less than a whole or more than a whole? And so there's more than one way to think about it. But what I would suggest is that if you were going to be faced with this problem, you'd want to go ahead and change 7/8 into 16ths. And then you'd get 14 because you know that 7/8, if we want to change that into 16ths, you double it, so you'd get 14, and you'd say, oh, 14 plus 4 is 18 sixteenths, so I actually have more than 1 or greater than 1. But this kind of problem, just because 1 is greater and 1 is less, it could go either way still. You have to do some more work to decide. And you can decide more than one way. This is the easiest way, I think, to show you. And that's it. All I want to talk about today with those. Find the value of a sum, whether it's greater than or less than 1. Have a great day.